Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Skyrim. My name's Camel, and in this video I'm going to be showing you all of Skyrim's unique spells. Now, just to clarify, a unique spell means it is only found in one specific location, is a reward for completing a specific quest, or can only be purchased from one specific vendor. Also, I don't have any perks in any of the magic skill trees, so these are all the base spell effects. So now that that confusion's been blown out the door like autumn leaves, let's head outside. And what do you know, we already were outside. So now that we're outside, I'm going to be showing you, first off, the Skyrim unique alteration spells. So first up we have Ash Shell. Targets that fail to resist are immobilized in hardened ash for 30 seconds. This is an adept level spell and costs 121 magicka to cast. We'll test this on this Imperial soldier here. Next up we have Transmute. Transmutes one piece of unrefined iron ore to silver or silver ore to gold if the caster is carrying any. This is an adept level spell and costs 48 gold to cast. Now I have one piece of iron ore in my inventory, so if we cast it once it will turn that iron ore to silver ore, as you can see in the top left corner. And now that I have a silver ore in my inventory, if I cast it again, it will turn that silver ore into gold ore. Again, also seen in the top left corner. So next up we have Ash Rune. Cast on a nearby surface, it explodes when enemies are nearby, immobilizing them in hardened ash for 30 seconds. This is an expert level spell and costs 201 magicka to cast. So we'll test it out on these Imperial soldiers here. Next up we have Ebony Flesh, improves the caster's armor rating by 100 points for 60 seconds. This is an expert level spell and costs 164 magicka to cast. Next up we have Paralyze. Targets that fail to resist are paralyzed for 10 seconds. This is an expert level spell and costs 217 magicka to cast. Next up we have Dragonhide. Caster ignores 80% of all physical damage for 30 seconds. This is a master level spell and costs 403 magicka to cast. Next up we have Mass Paralysis. All targets in the area that fail to resist are paralyzed for 15 seconds. This is a master level spell and costs 452 magicka to cast. And stay down. Ah, well, he wasn't listening, obviously. And lastly, for Skyrim's unique alteration spells, we have Equilibrium. Convert 25 points of health into magicka per second. Caster can be killed by this effect. This is a novice level spell and costs 0 magicka per second to cast, although it does cost health, as you will see here. And next up we have Skyrim's unique conjuration spells, and first up we have the Bound Dagger. Creates a magic dagger for 120 seconds, sheath it to dispel. This is a novice level spell and costs 15 magicka to cast. Next up we have Conjure Bone Man. Summons a Bone Man Archer from the Soul Can for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. This is an apprentice level spell and costs 38 magicka to cast. And there is our Bone Man Archer. Next up we have Flaming Familiar. Summons a Flaming Familiar which will charge into battle and explode. This is an apprentice level spell and costs 17 magicka to cast. Next up we have Summon Arvak. Summons Arvak in the Soul Cairn or Tamriel Wilderness to act as your steed. This is an apprentice level spell and costs 40 magicka to cast. And there he slash she is, Arvak, our purple flaming undead steed, what every young girl dreams of. Alright, you can go now. No. Okay, you can stay there then. Next up, we have Conjure Ash Spawn. Summons an Ash Spawn for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. This is an adept level spell and costs 55 Magicka to cast. Arvak's still here, apparently. Jesus Christ. Give this man some moisturizer. Next up, we have Conjure Mist Man. Summon a Mist Man from the Soul Can for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. This is an adept level spell and costs 57 Magicka to cast. And there it is. Mist Man. I'm gonna say he. There he is. It's a man. It's a Mist Man. Next up, we have Conjure Seeker. Summons a Seeker for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. This is an adept level spell and costs 46 Magicka to cast. And there it is, the Seeker. This is Kim Kardashian's final form. Next up, we have Conjure Ash Guardian. Creates an Ash Guardian that guards that location until destroyed. Consumes a Heartstone from your inventory without which it will be hostile. This is an expert level spell and costs 101 Magicka to cast. Now, I don't have any Heartstones in my inventory, so this will be hostile. Alright, here we go. Jesus. Come here, you little bastard. What have we done? This thing's so powerful. Let's try this then. Kill all. Boys, take that. By the gods, collect bounty from Brill? Next up, we have Command Daedra. Powerful summoned and raised creatures are put under your control. This is an expert level spell and costs 72 Magicka to cast. Now, unfortunately, there are no powerful summoned Daedra around here, and I could summon one, but then it would already be under my control, so I'm just gonna cast it at the air. Amazing. Next up, we have Conjure Dremora Lord. Summons a Dremora Lord for 60 seconds. This is an expert level spell and costs 106 Magicka to cast. There it is, our Dremora Lord. Next up, we have Conjure Storm Atronach. Summons a Storm Atronach for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. This is an expert level spell and costs 95 Magicka to cast. There it is, our Storm Atronach. Next up, we have Conjure Wrathman. Summons a Wrathman from the Soul Can for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. This is an expert level spell and costs 89 Magicka to cast. And there it is, our Wrathman. Next up, we have Dread Zombie. Reanimate a very powerful dead body to fight for you for 60 seconds. This is an expert level spell and costs 89 Magicka to cast. Rise, champion. Oh, his eyes are still closed. Oh. Morning. Next up, we have Expel Daedra. Powerful summon Daedra creatures are sent back to oblivion. This is an expert level spell and costs 64 Magicka to cast. Well, alright. You take this. Ah, there we go. Expel back to oblivion. Next up, we have Flame Thrall. Summons a Flame Atronach. Permanently, this is a master level spell and costs 267 Magicka to cast. And there it is, our permanent Flame Thrall. Next up, we have a dead thrall. Reanimate a dead body permanently to fight for you. Only works on people. I do believe that's meant to say dread thrall. That's what it's called on the wiki. And the other reanimate corpse spells are called dread, so I do think this should be dread thrall. This is a master level spell and costs 296 magicka to cast. And here he is, our dead slash dreadfall. Next up we have Frost Thrall, summons a Frost Atronach permanently. This is a master level spell and costs 326 magicka to cast. There it is, our permanent Frost Thrall. And next up we have Storm Thrall, summons a Storm Atronach permanently. This is a master level spell and costs 356 magicka to cast. And there it is, our permanent Storm Atronach, or Storm Thrall. Now next up we have Summon Arneel's Shade. Summons the Shade of Arneel Gain for 60 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. This is an apprentice level spell and costs 0 magicka to cast. And there he is, Arneel's Shade. And lastly for Skyrim's unique conjuration spells, we have Summon Unbound Dremora. Summons an Unbound Dremora for 999 seconds. This is a novice level spell and costs 29 magicka to cast. So I just read up about it on the internet, and apparently some people are having issues after gaining that spell from the quest where they use it and nothing happens, as you've seen just here. So that is unfortunate. Now we're moving on to Skyrim's unique destruction spells. Now first up we have a special two. We have Freeze and Ignite. Now, these two spells you can only use and will only show up in your spellbook when you are wearing Azidal's Ring of Arcana. I cover this ring in my Skyrim Unique Jewelry video, the link to which you can click right here. Where I cover it more in detail, you can click the link and it will skip straight to the part in the video where I'm covering Azidal's Ring of Arcana. And as you can see, allows you to cast the spells Ignite and Freeze. So I have it equipped. Therefore, I have Ignite and Freeze in my inventory, so we're going to start off with Freeze. Freeze! A spike of ice that does 20 points of frost damage to health and stamina and slows the target for 15 seconds. This is an apprentice level spell and costs 14 magicka to cast. Take this, and this, and this. Now that we've slowed him down, let's check out Ignite. Ignite! A blast of flame that sets the target on fire, doing 4 points of damage per second for 15 seconds. This is an apprentice level spell and costs 14 magicka to cast. Yeah! Like this. Done. Dealt with in the appropriate Skyrim manner. Next up we have Whirling Cloak. For 60 seconds, opponents in melee range have a chance to be flung away. This is an adept level spell and costs 163 magicka to cast. We need more enemies. Take this! Haha! Fling! That's actually a pretty cool little spell here. Next up we have Blizzard. Target takes 20 points of frost damage for 10 seconds plus stamina damage. This is a master level spell and costs 533 magicka to cast. Well, that was rather fancy. Next up we have Firestorm, a 100 point fiery explosion centered on the caster. Does more damage to closer targets. This is a master level spell and costs 688 magicka to cast. Hmm. And next up we have Lightning Storm. Target takes 75 points of shock damage per second to health and half that to Magicka. This is a master level spell and costs 66 Magicka to cast. Per second, I should add. Dragon Ball Z, eat your heart out. Next up we have Arneel's Convection. Burns the target for 1 point per second. Targets on fire take extra damage. This is a novice level spell and costs 0 Magicka per second to cast. A fairly useless spell, besides the use that it has for the particular quest that you get it for. And lastly, for Skyrim's unique destruction spells, we have Vampiric Drain. Absorb 5 points of health per second from the target. This is a novice level spell and costs 8 Magicka to cast. Per second, I would imagine. Take this! Ha ha! Give your life force to the more powerful undead here. Me! Ha 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 ha! Now we're moving on to Skyrim's unique illusion spells, and first up we have Frenzy Rune. Targets up to level 20 that fail to resist are frenzied for 30 seconds. This is an adept level spell and costs 134 Magicka to cast. Haha, take that. What happened? Ah, they are frenzied. Some of them are being ganged up on. 5 of them are down. Alright, this is getting quite boring now, so let's do the old kill all command boars. There we go, see you later. Now, next up for Skyrim's unique illusion spells, we have Invisibility. A caster is invisible for 30 seconds. Activating an object or attacking will break the spell. This is an expert level spell and costs 161 Magicka to cast. So let's see here. Now I'm here, and now I'm still here, but you can't see me. Now let's activate something, shall we? Okay, can't activate that. Nothing over here to activate. Well, the garden of non-activation, apparently. Why don't we attack? See what that does. Okay, so that comes out. We'll do it again. Let's activate the bucket, and it comes out. And next up we have Pacify. Creatures and people up to level 25 won't fight for 60 seconds. This is an expert level spell and costs 140 Magicka to cast. Hey, hey! Oh my god, get off me! There we go. Completely pacified. Absolutely harmless now. And next we have Rout. Creatures and people up to level 25 flee from combat for 30 seconds. This is an expert level spell and costs 152 Magicka to cast. Run! Flee for your lives. Or squat in my garden. Whatever suits you. Next we have Call to Arms. Targets have improved combat skills, health and stamina for 10 minutes. This is a master level spell and costs 316 Magicka to cast. Very useful for buffing friends. And I think I just buffed the enemies. Yes, I did. Excellent. Next up, we have Harmony. Creatures and people up to level 31 nearby won't fight for 60 seconds. This is a master level spell and costs 507 Magicka to cast. Complete harmony. Now that there is complete harmony, we have Hysteria. Creatures and people up to level 31 flee from combat for 60 seconds. This is a master level spell and costs 418 Magicka to cast. Run! Next up, we have the spell Mayhem. Creatures and people up to level 31 will attack anyone nearby for 60 seconds. This is a master level spell and costs 477 Magicka to cast. Lovely day, isn't it? Little did they know. Now I'm getting the fuck out of here. Excellent. Mayhem. Pure mayhem. Yes, that too, but this mayhem. And lastly, for Skyrim's unique illusion spells, we have the Vision of the Tenth Eye. See what others cannot. This is a novice level spell, and casting costs 0 magicka. I do believe this is for a quest, so it's only really useful for that specific quest. And no, I actually could not think of a joke to go with see what others cannot. How about Tony Abbott's good side? If you don't know who Tony Abbott is, oh, just look him up on YouTube, and weep at the fact that he is the leader of Australia. Here we go, Vision of the Tenth Eye. See what others cannot. Boys, yes, like I said, it's for a quest, not really useful at all. And next up we have Skyrim's unique restoration spells. And first up we have Necromantic Healing. Heals the undead target 11 points per second, but not the living, Atronachs, or machines. This is an apprentice level spell and costs 18 magicka per second to cast. I have no damaged undead targets, or for that matter, any undead targets at all. So, I'll just cast this at the air. Whoa, crazy stuff. Next up for Skyrim's unique restoration spells, we have Sunfire. Ball of sunlight that does 25 points of damage to undead. This is an apprentice level spell, and casting it costs 11 magicka. Take this, you foul scoundrel. You bandit of bones, you fiend, die! Die at the fingertips of justice! Yeah, it's an alright spell, I guess. Next up, for Skyrim's unique restoration spells, we have Close Wounds. Heals the caster 110 points. This is an add-up level spell and costs 61 magicka to cast. And back to full health in no time. Next up, we have Greater Ward. Increases armor rating by 80 points and negates up to 80 points of spell damage or effect. This is an add-up level spell and costs 41 magicka per second to cast. Whoa, that ward is so big it could be part of a hospital. Next up, we have Heal Other. Heals the target 82 points, but not undead, Atronachs, or machines. This is an add-up level spell and costs 39 magicka to cast. Now that I have a damaged other, I shall heal that other. 82 points, there you go, and 82 points again, there you are. Now next up we have Heal Undead. Heals the undead target for 82 points, but not the living, Atronachs, or machines. This is an add-up level spell and costs 55 magicka to cast. So let's see if we can save this skeleton before he dies. Don't die on me! Oh my god, we just got him. He's kneeling to his king. Kneel before me. Wench, slave, peasant, be healed and be mine. And next up for Skyrim's unique restoration spells, we have Poison Rune. Now, I don't know why this is a restoration spell, but it is. So, Poison Rune, targets that fail to resist take 3 points of poison damage per second for 30 seconds. This is an add-up level spell, and it costs 119 magicka to cast. Good day, gentlemen. Oh yes, I forgot how powerful these bastards are. Let's try this on a weaker enemy, shall we? On these very unladylike bandits, we shall test the poison rune. Oh my god, they're pretty strong as well, but not strong enough to withstand the power of the poison rune. Can't handle that, eh? What's going on here? Oh! That looked fucking weird. That looked weird. Next up, we have the Grand Healing. Heals everyone close to the caster for 220 points. This is an expert level spell and costs 122 magicka to cast. Gonna use Equilibrium here to get our health down, and then we'll go boom and Grand Healing this up. And there we go, Grand Healing. That was rather grand. Next up, we have Stendarr's Aura. For 60 seconds, undead in melee range take 10 points of sun damage per second. This is an add-up level spell, and it costs 119 magicka to cast. Die, foul beasts. Die, spawns of Dagoth. Next up we have Turn Undead. Undead up to level 13 flee for 30 seconds. This is an add-up level spell and it costs 81 magicka to cast. Flee, run, You coward! You don't have an honest bone in your body! What are you, spineless? You coward! Boneless! Wicked! Next up we have Vampire's Bane, sunlight explosion that does 40 points of damage in a 15 foot radius to undead. This is an add-up level spell, and casting it costs 34 magicka. Take this! Whoa. And this! And this! Next up, we have Circle of Protection. Undead up to level 20, entering the circle will flee. This is an expert level spell, and it costs 82 magicka to cast. See ya, mate. Why are you running away? It's not like I dropped a circle of protection or anything. Jesus. Next, we have Repel Undead. All affected undead up to level 16 flee for 30 seconds. This is an expert level spell and it costs 170 magicka to cast. Take that. And this. It does jump between undead. Oh my god. You can see there, like a chain effect. Who's left? No one. Next up we have Turn, Greater Undead. Undead up to level 21, flee for 30 seconds. This is an expert level spell and it costs 128 magicka to cast. Take this! See ya. Next we have Guardian Circle. Undead up to level 35, entering the circle will flee. Caster heals 20 health per second inside it. This is a master level spell and it costs 345 magicka to cast. Flee. Yes, I'm running out of things to say for these fleeing spells. Run. Yes. Haha. Take that. And lastly for Skyrim's unique restoration spells, and also lastly for Skyrim's unique spells, we have Bane of the Undead. Sets undead up to level 30 on fire and makes them flee for 30 seconds. This is a master level spell and it costs 476 magicka to cast. Feel my power! Yes, prepare yourselves! Flee! Scatter! Scatter like your bones will across the ground when I destroy you! I will banish you back to the rotting realm from whence you were risen! For I am God in this kingdom! And there we have it. That concludes our Skyrim Unique Spells video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like. Don't forget to leave a comment if you think I left any spells out. Also, let me know which spells you use and which spells you think are cool. Don't forget to share this video amongst your family and friends. And as always, if you did enjoy this video and you would like to see videos similar to this one, please subscribe. It helps me know that people are interested in these kind of videos and therefore will result in me making more of these videos in the future. And also, I have a new series coming out, which is Skyrim Unobtainable Items. There's going to be three separate videos. The links will be on screen once they're complete, and as you can probably see, there are also the links to all of my other Skyrim unique videos, so feel free to check those out. So once again, I would like to thank you very much for watching, and now I'm going to leave you while you click on one of these links, and I will see you in the next video. See you later, alligator. Don't forget your toilet paper. Is that how it goes? I'm not sure. Tree puncher. Run, flee, you weak. Oh, God. That's really hard doing that.